Hello everyone, today we will be studying about the relationship between adrenal gland and oral surgery. First of all, I have a question for you. The gold standard test for primary adrenal failure is the blood glucose test, ACTH stimulation test, serum creatinine level or bone test. Let's go in detail. The ACTH stimulation test is performed to examine the response of the adrenal gland to an exogenously administered dose of ACTH. Normal patients have a doubling of the serum cortisol level after a dose of ACTH. The serum cortisol level should rise to greater than 20% at least milligram per deciliter if there is an adequate adrenal function. An inadequate response suggests that adrenal gland hypofunction. About 20 milligram of hydrocorticosone is secreted by the adrenal cortex daily. This is you need to remember. During stress, the cortex can increase the output to 200 milligram daily. Always remember, patients taking steroids or people with disease of adrenals will have decreased ability to produce more glucocorticoids, that is hydrocorticosone, in times of stress, for example in times of extractions. The reason for this is secretion of glucocorticoids is stimulated by ACTH, a hormone produced in the anterior pituitary. The pituitary responds to stress by increasing ACTH output and therefore glucocorticoid production increases. A relative lack of glucocorticoids will also increase output of ACTH. An overabundance of circulating systemic steroids will inhibit production of ACTH. Large doses of steroids repress ACTH production, which leads to atrophy of adrenal gland. Now let's go to the another question. A person who has been on suppressive dose of steroids will select all that apply. A person who has been on suppressive dose of steroids will take as long as a year to regain full adrenal cortical function, take as long as a month to regain full adrenal cortical function, or may show signs of hyperpigmentation, or does not require consultation with a physician prior to surgery. Now let's go to the details. The correct answer is take as long as a year to regain full adrenal cortical function, may show signs of hyperpigmentation. Both are the correct answer. Now let's go in details. The following guidelines may help determine if a patient's adrenal function is suppressed. However, if any doubt exists, consult the patient's physician before performing surgery. These are the guidelines. People on small doses, that is 5 mg prednisolone per day, will have suppression when they have been on regimen for a month. People taking the equivalence of 100 mg cortisol per day, that is 20 to 30 mg prednisolone per day, will have abnormal cortical function in a week. Short-term therapy, 1 to 3 days of even high-dose steroids will not alter adrenal cortical function. A person who has been on suppressive dose of steroids will take as long as a year to regain full adrenal cortical functions. Patients with adrenal insufficiency are hyperpigmented. Why? This is most noticeable on the buccal mucosa and labial mucosa, although other areas such as gingiva may be involved. But why there is hyperpigmentation? The hyperpigmentation is a result of hypersecretion of adrenocorticotropic hormone, which can stimulate melanocytes to produce pigment, so that there is hyperpigmentation. Patients with decreased adrenal gland hormone production experience weakness, weight loss, or orthostatic hypotension, and they can also express nausea and vomiting. Patients with severe adrenal insufficiency cannot increase steroid production in response to stress, and in extreme situations may have cardiovascular collapse. It is important that an adrenally insufficient patient have adequate steroid replacement, since the stress of oral surgery can precipitate adrenal crashes. There is high chance of precipitation of adrenal crashes during the extractions or any other stressful treatments in oral surgery. So there must be an adequate steroid replacement for that during the procedure. In adrenal crisis, an intravenous or intramuscular injection of hydrocorticosone must be given immediately, supportive treatment of low blood pressure with IV fluids is usually necessary. Hospitalization is required for adequate treatment and monitoring. Now let's go to the another question. Patients with glucocorticoid hypersecretion have ectopic ACTH syndrome, Menfos Cushing syndrome, or Addison disease. The correct answer is Cushing syndrome. Now let's go to the details about the Cushing syndrome. Cushing syndrome is a hormonal disorder caused by prolonged exposure of body tissues to high level of hormone cortisol. This results in characteristic changes in body hiatus, including moon phases, truncal obesity, muscular wasting, and hirsutism, sometimes called hypercortisolism. It is relatively rare and most commonly affects adults aged 20 to 50. The female to male ratio for the incidence is approximately 5:1. Patients with Cushing syndrome are often hypertensive because of fluid retention. Long-term glucocorticoid excess can result in decreased collagen production, a tendency to bruise easily, poor wound healing, and osteoporosis. They are often at increased risk of infection. Laboratory studies may reveal increased blood glucose level because of interference with carbohydrate metabolism, and examination of the peripheral blood smear may demonstrate slight decrease in eosinophil and lymphocyte counts. The patient's cardiovascular status must be evaluated and treated if necessary prior to the surgery. Also note that the most common cause of Cushing syndrome is a tumor in the pituitary gland. This is another MCQ. Case-based question. A 52-year-old woman requests removal of painful mandibular second molar. She tells you that she has not rested for 2 days and nights because of the pain. Her medical history is unremarkable, except that she takes 20 mg of pirnozolone daily for erythema multiforme. How do you treat this patient? You will have patient discontinue the pirnozolone for 2 days prior to extraction. You will give steroid supplementation and remove the tooth with local anesthesia and sedation, or you will instruct the patient to take 3 grams of amoxicillin 1 hour prior to extraction, or no special treatment is necessary prior to extraction. The correct answer is you will give steroid supplementation and remove the tooth with local anesthesia and sedation. Let's go to the details about this. The fear here is that the patient may not have sufficient adrenal cortex secretion to withstand the stress of extraction without taking additional steroids. This holds true for any patient who has been treated with steroid therapy. Patients with adrenal insufficiency, patients on daily steroid therapy, and patients who have recently finished a course of steroids should receive steroid supplementation for dental procedures. I'm going to repeat this again because this is very important. Patients with adrenal insufficiency, patients on daily steroid therapy, and patients who have recently finished a course of steroids should receive steroid supplementation for dental procedures. The concerns about adrenal insufficiency should be raised on the basis of clinical history. In the majority of the cases, the dentist should ask, is it known that the patient's adrenal gland do not function adequately? Is the patient on chronic steroid therapy at doses of prednisone higher than 50 mg per day? Or has the patient been on steroid therapy at doses of prednisone higher than 50 mg per day within the last 2 weeks? If the answer to any of these questions is yes, the dentist should assume that the patient will need stress dose steroids. Now we will be studying about the general guidelines for the management of patients on steroid therapy. First is steroid supplementation in patients who can develop adrenal insufficiency. Another is shorter appointments are better. Minimize the stress as much as you can. Use sedation techniques when appropriate. Modify dental plan when appropriate. The major goal in this patient is to avoid precipitating of adrenal insufficiency. Always remember, erythema multiforme is a hypersensitivity syndrome which is characterized by polymorphous eruption of skin and mucous membrane, that is macules, papules, nodules, vesicles or bulli are target lesions which are seen in this case. We also called it as bull's eye shaped lesion. A severe form of this condition is known as Stevens-Johnson syndrome. This patient may be receiving moderate doses of systemic corticosteroids and therefore may be unable to withstand the stress of an extraction. Consultation with the physician is absolutely necessary before treating these patients.